Ok, bonsoir.
2 seconds. Raise your hand if you want a question. Start with Sam right over there.
Hello, Maurizio. How do you analyse that game, given that there was a lot of pressure from City, a lot of shots, and you get a point out of it?
How I analyse the game?
Yeah.
I think they were better. I think they dominate the game. It's so clear that was so clear the game. Of course, with the different circumstances, both team, I think I am happy with the result. It was a very positive result for us. 1 point here. I think, yes, happy because the point, but like I told after the game against Aston Villa, we need to improve a lot. I think the team or the squad is still unsettled. We need to wait until the transfer window in Europe be closed to see which player we are going to have, and of course that is not easy, never easy, and we will face today the last Premier League winner. The last 2 seasons they were winning, they are a very consistent team, improving every season, signing players that came from different teams that they were winning, like Cancelo from Juventus. You know, we are in a different process. That is why we cannot compare both teams. The most important is the faith and the belief that we show today and the character, because for 2 times going down in the score, come back on the result, and after 1-0, 1-1, and of course after 2-1, 2-2. And in the way that we fight, I'm so happy. But in the same time, I am critic because we need to improve a lot. But in the same time, I think we are going to improve with this type of result, positive result, 4 points after 2 difficult games. I think it's a very positive start from the season, of the season.
Mauricio, you've put a lot of faith in Kyle Walker-Peters at right back. What's the plan at the end of last season for him to start this season as your first choice right back, and how pleased have you been with his first 2 performances?
I think still he needs to improve, you know. He needs to improve. He's still so young. It's not easy when you are a backup player. You know, your excitement and your motivation is massive, and when you have the possibility, it's like an amazing opportunity, no? And you are focus 200% to try to show that you can play. But when you start to feel the responsibility that you are the first choice, we'll see how he's going to behave. Today, I think, was a massive proof to play again one of the best offensive players like Sterling. I think when I think good, another that thing that needs to improve, but still is so young. I think the experience is massive for him.
Okay. You seem to be saying that the uncertainty in the transfer window is affecting performance at the moment. Are you confident that will improve in September? Because you may have players who don't want to be here, who didn't get a move, or you may have lost players.
If I am agree, or what is your question is?
Do you think it will improve in September? Because you may still have issues, because maybe a player's still at the club rather left, or maybe you've lost a key player by September, so are you confident?
Yes. I think it's not an excuse. I am not complaining about the situation. They only explain the situation. The situation is that, of course, we need to wait what is going to happen with our squad. You know, maybe some player are still situation that thing can happen. We are not a close squad. That no one is going to move, maybe no one move, but of course that circumstance that still is open, the market in Europe make difficult in the way that we work, and this type of situation doesn't help the coaching staff to create a good dynamic. Of course that is we are going to start. We start our 6th season on the Tottenham, and I think we are world champion, adapting ourselves to the different circumstances, and it's a great experience. We are going to be one of the best coaches and coaching staff in the world, adapting on all the circumstances. Today, when you play again a team like Manchester City, with all the circumstances that we have inside our team, I think 2-2, the result 2-2 and got 1 point, and it seems massive credit to the team, to everyone that is working hard to try to, you know, to keep going working, trying that not be focused in the circumstance and try to be positive, faith, hope, and that is massive. I don't know if the people realize or no, but, you know, I don't care about that. Only that the circumstances are not the best, and of course, the challenge is massive. So happy because the will of the player, the commitment of the player, with all the circumstances, we are fighting to try to get a good result to deliver for the club and for our fans, of course.
Okay, do two more. One from Phil, and then whoever wants the last one. Phil's in.
When the goal went in right at the end, did you actually think there was any sort of problem at all at first? And how would you feel if that decision had gone against your team for the same reason?
No, I told before your colleague, I accept now the VAR is in football. I was a little bit critic in the past. And of course, that wasn't for the people nice to see it or to listen from me. I love the football that was 30 years ago, 25 years ago, 20 years ago, 40 years ago. Still now I am watching football from the past. You know, I love with the referee, because the referee is the boss, it's not another person that can take decision. You know, if the referee see or not see, or it's wrong or right, you know, that was the nice thing in football. But of course, now we cannot give the back to the technology and the new era in football, and we need to accept. Of course, I'm going to accept the rules. I accept the rules. I accept that when it's for me, and I'm going to accept in the future because, for sure, it's going to some decision is going to be again us, for sure. And I'm going to accept in the same way, with the same face, and of course, accepting that the rules are the rules, the VAR is there, and it's part of the game today.
Yeah, the massive point I made, the initial point, though, as well. Did you even know there was a problem at first, or were you just thought?
Yes, Jesus told me, and we were watching the situation, because to concede in the last minute from the corner, yes, I was a little, we were upset. And in that moment, was the VAR checking, and Jesus said to me, he's humble. And yes, again, no, it's the same emotion like a few months ago when it happened in the Champions League. You know, you are out and you are in, you know, and but still a few minutes more to play. You know, it's unbelievable, this stadium with the VAR, no? And we Tottenham, because not happened with another team.
Okay, finish with Ali down here.
Mauricio, after the incident, you were talking to Pep for quite a long time. Can I just ask kind of what the conversation was?
No, we were talking about the VAR first, and of course it was a conversation because when we were in Barcelona, him in Barcelona and me in Espanyol, always every 6 months when we play again, always we met and play and talk. You know, because that is the habit of the is to make that picture in between the two managers. But here it's not like this, and it's difficult to find a way to meet sometime and to talk. It's true that we see each other in the Premier League meetings a few weeks ago. But in that moment, we keep going in different way, talking in conversation, in something we were agreeing, something we were disagreeing, you know. And then we spent 2 minutes that was good because we were... We're not focused in the game, we're focused in our conversation, you know? But everything okay.
Right, guys, thank you very much.
Thank you.